Hello friends, welcome, and I am going to discuss about hydroboration, one of the important organic reagent which is used for the reduction oxidation and mainly for the hydroboration.
Right. Hydroboration is known as reduction oxidation.
And that known as a reduction oxidation, right? We will see how that is reduction oxidation. First of all, you can see the starting materials where olefin reacts with the borans to give alcohol and this side product by reduction and oxidation. You can see first of all reduction of this double bond and then the oxidation in presence of H2O2 gives us this alcohol. Now we'll see how that steps goes through. You can see this is a intermediate step where reduction happens. This is a reduction procedure where double bond converts to single bond where oxidation state decreased, called as a reduction, and then the in presence of H2O2 NaOH this Br2 converts to OH. Now we'll see how that Br2 converting from Br2, how it is converting to OH. This is a step where a boron will be reacting with a H2O2 to give this intermediate, and where a migration of this R group from this boron to O and then gives us this compound, and in presence of then water OH minus will be getting this compound, and in presence of OH will be getting this alcohol. You can see here all the mechanism for the conversion of Br2 to OH, how it goes through. This reaction is known as a hydroboration reaction, and first of all reduction will happen and then oxidation gives us this alcohol, less substrate alcohol. Now we'll see in next slide detail what is this reaction, which mechanism follows this reaction, and what are the stereoselectivity, what are the regioselectivities we'll be seeing here. Actually mainly this reaction is known as a anti-Markovnikov addition will happen on this hydroboration reaction. Now how that anti-Markovnikov addition on triple bond to OH is happening we'll see here, and we have seen in previous slide also. Now you can see this is a borane diborane. Now this is a double bond or olefin we can say, and in presence of BH3 will be this mechanism this will follow, because BH3 boron will be having a minus charge and H will be having a slightly boron will be having a positive charge and H will be having a slight minus charge, so that it will be adding on a olefin in this fashion like a four member transition state, and then this is actually product, this called as a reduction and also called as a hydroboration, right? Now we'll see this reaction is a reversible reaction. Mainly syn addition will be happening. This hydrogen and boron will be attacking on this olefin in a syn fashion, not on an anti fashion, right? So after oxidation also, whatever hydroxy is coming, that also will be on a syn fashion. Here OH will come also, that also will be in a syn fashion with this hydrogen. So syn addition will be happening in this reaction. Attack from least hindered phase. Now mainly attack from the least hindered side will be happening. Now I will discuss in next slide how that is that will be going. Boron attached to a least substituted carbon, right? First, whenever boron is attaching to the carbon, that step goes through a Markovnikov addition, but the overall product will be anti-Markovnikov, right? Now I will show that how it goes through and how that is overall reaction is anti-Markovnikov, but first step of boration is a Markovnikov steps, because olefin will be attacking on boron, and that step is called as a Markovnikov step, but overall addition of water is anti-Markovnikov step. Right, now we'll see rate, how rate is increasing and when rate is decreasing. Rate increase by electron donating substrate on olefin. Whenever olefin is electron rich, that time the rate of reaction will be increased, because boron will be electron deficient, so that whenever electron rich olefin is there, that will react faster obviously, right? Increase by strain of olefin. Whenever strain or a more reactive olefin is there, that will be reacting faster. That is a common concept. Increased by decreased steric hindrance of olefin. Whenever steric hindrance on olefin is less, that time the rate will be faster, right? Now we'll see some of the another reagents, like a, this is a BH3 normal reagent, then another reagent is a disamyl borane, then thexyl borane and 9 BBN. These are the another formats of borane which are so important and so famous. Now you can see how it is a regioselectivity and what is the actually how steric factors affect on the addition reaction or how steric factors matters for the product, right? Now we'll see here, we have seen that is boron addition will be on a less hindered side. Now you can see how less hindered side it goes through and how much product it will be giving towards the less hindered side. You can see this side is a C4H9CH and double bond CH2 right here. This is a more substituted side where this R group is there, but this is a less substituted side, right? Whenever we are adding here BH3, we are getting 94% yield. Whenever we are adding all reagents giving a less substituted side product. You can see in this case also where a less substituted side giving a 84, 94, 98, 95. You can see here also this is a less substituted side, less hindered side, because here is a 4-3 carbons, here is a 1 carbon in this R group. That's what this is a less hindered side, and boron will be giving a more products in this side only. You can see here also this is a 2 R groups are there where here nothing is there. So 99% in this side. You can see here also 1 R group, same as like this, but this is a less hindered side. So formation of alcohol on this side only. So mainly reaction says that the first addition of borane with a Markovnikov's rule, and then overall addition is anti-Markovnikov's, goes towards a less hindered side. This is one of the regioselectivity of this reaction. You can see. Then now we'll see here steric factor. Electronic factor, and a group on the aromatic rings. How it matters for the addition of Br2. Whenever electron donating groups are there, addition of borane to towards a less hindered side is a more product dominant, because you can see here H normal aromatic ring, and they are giving here 81% yield, and on the another side this is a more more substituted side where a less yield they we got in hydroboration. And whenever OM is there in presence of this X, this is a electron rich center now, because OME is a sending electron towards the aromatic ring. That's what this bond will be polarized towards say this this carbon, and that's what the because of electron or electronic factor this side yield will be more. That's what 93% boron will be added on a less hindered side or on the this carbon, right? CF3Cl, this is electron withdrawing electron withdrawing group which removes the electron from the aromatic ring. That's what this bond will polarize towards this carbon, and the this more substituted borane will be forming little bit more. You can see here previously whenever electron donating compound were the groups was there where 7% 19% yield was there, and whenever electron withdrawing groups came, you can see 27 and 35. Now there another substituents also there where OET is there. You can see now I said here whenever electron donating groups are there, this bond will be polarized right towards outside. That's what yield gives a more to for the less hindered or less substituted borane. Now you can see this is a OET here will be having a lone pairs, which lone pairs gives more electron density on this carbon. That's what 100% yield on this carbon, right? You can see here on this carbon 100% yield they are giving, right? Because of the electron pair on this oxygen which comes in a delocalization, and the electron rich center will generate on this carbon, right? Now you can see here trimethyl silyl is there, which is electron withdrawing, right? Which is a electron withdrawing which makes electron will attract electron towards this carbon, and because of the electron rich center, this will attack on a borane, and then minus hydride will attack on this carbon. That's what it gives a 95% yield. You can see here R groups where isopropyl, we have seen where electron bulky groups are there, then this will be a hindered site. So mainly this is a less hindered site which gives us more yield, and then you can see here gradually here both boranes gives us less substituted more yield, right? Less substituted hydroboration. But even all the reagents in presence of trimethylsilyl, if there is a trimethylsilyl, we have seen here, if trimethylsilyl is there, then the carbon where trimethylsilyl is there, their 95% yield is there. You can see here where hydroboration happens. You can see even here also where another borane gives, another borane gives, BH3 only gives towards this carbon, and another borane gives towards a less substituted carbon, right? We'll see some of the other distereoselectivity. Endocyclic olefin, here also predominantly attack from the least hindered site. You can see here yield ratio they have given here. We can see from the less hindered site we will be getting more yield. From this side there is a less yield because of this steric factor of this R groups. This side attack is impossible because of less hindered side attack is from this side of hydroboration, right? This is a cis addition attack or a least hindered side it will be attacking, then least substituted position will be more predominantly giving hydroboration. Now you can see here, just now I have discussed that it will be attacking from the less hindered side. You can see here this is a less hindered side, and 62% from this side. You can see here also 57, then this 43, and then we will be getting this. Now we will discuss some of the other exocyclic olefin. If there is a exocyclic olefin, you can see from the less substituted side it is giving a 67% yield, and from the more hindered side it is not giving more yield for the hydroboration, right? Hydroboration will be on this carbon only, not on this carbon. But there also is a steric factor. If there is a steric factor in cyclohexane, this chair formed cyclohexane, from this side, there will be less attack from this side. This is a distereoselectivity for the chiral tree. Now you can see here from this side, 67% yield is there, right? Now a cyclic olefination. You can see here also, this is a less hindered side, that's what boron is coming from that side and opposite to this methyl group, because we have seen that whenever attack is happening, which will be on opposite side of the already present R groups, right? So that the this both groups will be trans to each other because of the addition of syn boron addition. That's what we'll be getting this alcohol, right? Right here, this is a less electron less hindered side. That's what here also hydroboration will happen, and then oxidation to gives us this alcohol. You can see now next. This kind of compounds which gives a predominantly this alcohol instead of going towards a less hindered side because of the coordination or because of the chelation of that borane to with this OR gives us this more predominantly this product, right, than the other, because you can see here also giving a less products. Now I will discuss some of the other. You can see here this is a they have shown mechanism for this one. A least hindered face opposite to the alkoxy group, which will be predominant, and regioselectivity avoids a R2B and H13 axial interactions. You can see now you see acyclic allylic alcohol and ethers. Here also same, which will be attacking from the less hindered side. You can see here, and this is a mechanism for that reactions. Now you can see direct boronation or direct boronation where a catechol borane is used in presence of H2O2. Now you can see catechol borane, whenever it is attacking on this, our whatever principle we followed up to now was like a borane will be attacking syn, it will be attacking a less hindered site, it will be a regioselective, and which is a anti-Morconic of addition. But now in this case, where oxygen having a phosphorus, but this phosphorus, whenever this boron is attacking from this side, which will not go predominantly towards the less substrate side because of the coordination, because of the chelation. This phosphorus will chelate with this boron and will be like attack on this carbon, right? And then hydride will be attacking on this carbon, right? Because of this, you will be getting a opposite product than the normal product of hydroboration reaction, right? You can see this product will be a predominant product. Then because you can see here, they have shown here how it is chelating this boron instead of attacking this boron towards a less hindered side. Because of the chelation property, boron will be attacked on the opposite regio isomer will be getting. You can see here also where a next now here a position of double bond is different. That's what still there is a normal reaction. If it is there, it will be attacking on, if this R group is normal R group like a CH3, CH2, CH3, then a predominantly boron will be attacking on this side. But because of the chelation property, this boron is going on this carbon, right? You can see they have shown here how that is going through. Right now, this is a same product for that one, catechol borane, where hydrolysis of this OACOS is happening. Right, these are the major product where because of this phosphorus will be getting a opposite regio isomer. Right now there I am showing some of the chiral asymmetric borination, where these are the reagents which will be used in a chiral hydroboration to get exactly what we want stereochemistry in hydroxylation. Right, thank you guys, thank you for watching our video. Like our video, comment and share, subscribe our channel Global Online University. Thank you.